Welcome to the Jay Martin Show. My name is Jay Martin, and my guest today is Michael Henriksen, the Chief Geological Officer of Torque Resources, for a quick update on Torque's work program. This is going to be a very busy company over the next 14 months. They're based down in Chile, copper gold projects. I've had Torque on the show before with their president and CEO, Sean Wallace. I wanted to get an update on the work program. So today we're going to be talking to Michael Henriksen. This is a quick interview, but it's jam-packed with important catalysts that I think you're going to want to know about if you're following Torque Resources. Here's Michael Henriksen. Enjoy. All right, here I am with Michael Henriksen, the Chief Geological Officer at Torque Resources. Michael, it's great to see you again.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Jay. Appreciate it.
I love your background, man. I'm jealous of where you're at. I'm in this cave over here, like my lair.
We're kind of on opposite ends of the spectrum on this one,
huh? Hey, look, my audience hasn't heard from Torque since my January conference in Vancouver. We put out a bit of content around that point, but you got a lot going on and you're set up for a very busy year and a half coming up here. And so what I want to do today is just introduce any new prospective shareholders to the story, what you guys are doing, where you're located, what you're all about. And for a lot of my viewers who are up to speed, give them the update, what they can expect in terms of news flow, where you're going to be working and where you're going to be allocating cash, therefore, you know, drills and such over the next year. So, you know, we're down in Chile. We've got a few projects. I want to focus on two of them today. Let's start with your favorite. You got to pick one.
Santa Cecilia. It's our flagship. It's located in the Maricunga Belt. We're surrounded by Norte Abierto, the joint venture between Barrick and Newmont, which is made up of the Caspiche and Cerro Casale deposits, combined 50 million ounces of gold and 13 billion pounds of copper. Endowment's extraordinary. And if you even step a little further out, a 10-kilometer radius, it's 80 million ounces of gold and, I don't know, 20 billion pounds of copper. So we're clearly in a fabulously endowed area. And you know, what I would tell you about this project that's so unique, it was very well known to all majors, really. I mean, everybody has known about this project for a long time, and it's kind of been isolated and suspended in time. The first round of work that got done there back in 88 to 1990 was done by Anglo, and they were looking for oxide gold, which was the flavor of the day back in the Maricunga, right? And they found some, you know, made a discovery. They also found some high-grade veins. And, you know, in 1990, gold price was bad. You know, they had other better opportunities. And so they moved on. And from there, that project sat on ice for 22 years until 2012. And in that 22 years, of course, porphyries were found right next door, you know, Caspiche, Cerro Casale, and the whole exploration model changed. At that point, the underlying owner is like, I wonder if I got a porphyry underneath this oxide gold. Drills a hole, 925 meters of 0.45 copper equivalent. Fabulous. Now, what's key about that is it's not the high-grade portion of the system. You know, like if you look at Caspiche, you know, that 25 million ounces and that 6.5 billion pounds of copper, most of it's contained in a fairly tight body, 150 meters across, porphyry, high-grade. That's when Exeter was drilling sort of 1,000 meters of a gram per ton and 0.4, 0.5% copper. And that's what we're shooting for ultimately. And that 925 meter intercept from 2012 is sort of that lower grade halo. Our job's to go find the high grade. And, you know, we got sort of, you know, right now we've sort of outlined 6-7 porphyry targets that we think that could deliver that, you know? So it's a really, amazing to be hunting for elephants. And, you know, from my experience at Newmont working around the world, honestly, it's like you're working with the major again. You're in that high potential zone, big looks, and you know, our job is to get the drill bit into this thing.
So talk to me about the work program. Like, what do you got planned for the next 12 months? What can we look for?
Yeah. So right now, you know, we're currently drilling it. Our first hole just completed here not too long ago. So that's fabulous to get that done. And we're on to our second hole. But because the thing was frozen in time, we had to actually go back and do sort of classic exploration 101, you know, like let's go collect a multi-element soil survey. You know, let's do some geologic mapping. Let's put this thing into context so that, you know, we can really get our targeting tight. And so we embarked on that in December. You know, we'll finish that surface work up in May. You'll see a lot of news flow from that in terms of our targeting. And it's really clear. I mean, you know, we're seeing very clear things to go drill, which is great. And we've expanded our knowledge a lot. And then from there, you'll see some drill results probably towards, you know, mid-July, end of July. That's a realistic time frame for those to come back. And then, of course, you know, we got to take a break on the drilling in the Chilean winter, right? So come the end of May, we'll stop.
Yeah.
And we'll come back probably in October and continue what we call the first phase of drilling, which, you know, about 15,000 meters. We want to get into this across all these targets to see what this is all about.
Okay. Okay. And you referenced the Newmont Barrick property right there, right? The Norte Abierto, am I pronounced that right?
That's right.
Which is, it's the fourth largest undeveloped gold project in the world. Is this?
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's an extraordinary piece of endowment. And really the way that we always viewed Santa Cecilia, I mean, quite frankly, when I first got there, I was, you know, obviously as a geologist, you want this thing badly, but yeah. We were also really aware of the leverage that Santa Cecilia provides. I mean, let's say you get the third leg of the stool and you find another 25 million ounces and another 7 billion pounds of copper, you know, does it become too big at that point? You know, those are the kinds of questions we asked ourselves really early. And we felt that, you know, that was a great piece of leverage. You know, obviously there was a lot of attention from majors, you know, I mean, Goldfields put in at a premium, they put in $15 million at $1 per share.
That's right.
You know, I can tell you that, when we first signed that deal, even prior to having access with the community, people were calling us, you know, because it was well known. They were like, kind of like, how'd you get it? And I just point to the Chilean team and who they are.
And that Goldfields investment, that $15 million in 2022 was specific, right, to Santa Cecilia exploration?
Yeah, primarily when they first started talking to us, I mean, they wanted that big look, you know, that was why they put their money in. And then, of course, while we were sort of talking with them, we made this Greenfields discovery at Margarita down on the coastal belt. And it also had a lot of gold in it, very rare for an IOCG. And they said, you know, you can probably throw a few million bucks that way. And we're okay with that because that's quite interesting what you're up to down there. So primarily for Santa Cecilia, but they recognized the potential of Margarita as well.
Got it. Okay. Well, let's use that as a segue to move down to your Greenfield project, Margarita on the coast. And what can you share about what you discovered thus far and any work programs? Because I know you got work programs coming up there as well.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Margarita is in the coastal Cordillera belt, so low altitude, 65 kilometers from Copiapó, one of the great mining centers of Chile. So infrastructure is great, power and roads, super well situated between Lundin's Candelaria mine and of course, Mantoverde mine from Capstone and their development project, Santo Domingo. You know, really, when we got there, it was a large hydrothermal system. And really, there was a little bit of copper oxide in the very corner of the project that had been drilled in the mid-90s. And I'm talking a small area, maybe 200 meters or 300 meters long. And the guy said to me, you know, there should be a sulfide source to this. And we started walking around and I saw breccia bodies everywhere. And I thought, I'll buy that. Let's take that ticket. And then, you know, lo and behold, we drilled 90 meters of 0.94% copper and I think 0.84 grams gold in our discovery hole in sulfides. And you know, it was a shock when the gold numbers came out, actually. We did not anticipate that at all. And quite frankly, gold had never really been sampled there before. So that gave us pause for thought. You know, we just had to say, okay, well, this is actually a gold-copper system or a copper-gold system. We're not really sure which. So we went back after that first discovery, extended it to make it 800 meters long, and then sort of took a bigger look at the property in general and found a bunch of other areas that had high concentration of gold in soils. We start working on those, and then all of a sudden you realize that a bunch of these target areas look almost identical to the discovery we made. And so what I would tell everybody is, you know, we're going to take that break from drilling at Santa Cecilia in the Chilean winter, go down to Margarita, expand on our discovery, which we believe is expandable, but also test a bunch of new targets.
Okay.
And what I would say is, if we can get a second body of mineralization discovered, the complexion of the project changes. And then you can start thinking ahead to things like, well, that's how sort of how Santo Domingo started. And that's how Mantoverde started, one body at a time. And you just keep working these things. IOCGs are a bit tricky, but you know, we've got a good grasp on it now after, you know, after a couple of rounds of drilling. And like I say, we should be drilling there, I'd imagine, towards the end of June. We'll put a minimum of 4,000 meters into it across some of these targets. And, you know, we can expect results from that, you know, come August, you know, early September. So we'll have a great set of catalysts with the drill bit moving forward.
Yeah, and very consistent news coming up. We're expecting results to come out of Santa Cecilia by mid-July. Work programs beginning in Margarita in June, with news flow maybe as early as August, if not at some point in September. I never put a hard date on when.
I don't like to do that either. But
So we get it. It's all good. You know, I love the proximity, and I know it's intentional. Obviously, you know, I'm familiar with your whole team behind Torc. Sean Wallace has been on the program a handful of times. Ivan Bebek as well, one of your advisors. You know, the duo with Keegan Resources and Caden Resources, two successful exits on their resume. And I think, you know, I understand the game plan here, right? It's let's find the minerals in close proximity to a potential acquirer, right? And
I mean, we're a discovery focused group, and we know where our strengths are. It's an exploration, and it's about monetizing a success. And, you know, I think for a company like us, for a junior, to be able to say, look, we're going to be drilling on a couple of discoveries for the next calendar year, that's a pretty awesome statement to make. And, you know, we are going to have a very catalyst rich 12 to 14 months in front of us. And ultimately, we just have to, hope for some market support here along the way. It's been tough, as we all know. And we hope to get recognition for, you know, for the discoveries that, you know, we've already made at Margarita and the ones that we hope to make at Santa Cecilia.
Yeah. Well, you can't control the market, but you definitely have the tailwind behind you. And I think we're positioned well here. I love the mission. Focus on exploration, monetize the success. By the way, it's something your team's done twice before in the past. It's always good to bet on a winning horse. And catalyst rich calendar for the next 14 months, which is what investors love to see, and shareholders as well. Look, Michael, thanks for coming back on the show and giving us the update, getting us back in front of my audience. And it sounds like we'll probably want to do this again midsummer, if not late summer, when we've got a couple pieces of news out that we can talk about.
Yeah, it'd be a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
All right. Pleasure's all mine.